I recently realized that I've been using my Prometheus beta QR for over 2 years, going on 3 years, and I still really like it. So in this video, I'm going to talk about why it's stuck around in my everyday carry rotation for so long, in spite of it having certain shortcomings. Now, the first and obvious shortcoming is the fact that this is really kind of a dinosaur in flashlight years. Flashlights have come along a tremendous amount in terms of UI and outputs in the last couple years, and this guy is very modest in that respect. But the reason why it stuck around is because of the innovation in the tail cap. Of course, this is the brass connector that I'm talking about that's attached with a steel spring. And the thing is this really allows the flashlight to be carried in a very unique way on a keychain. The thing is that I'm going to use my cell phone for a lot of kind of moonlight applications. If I need a flashlight, I'll just use the screen to get up the stairs in my house or something like that. When I'm going to want a flashlight is basically in a situation where digging around in my garage at night for something, it needs to be a little bit more powerful. But I don't necessarily want something huge, and it definitely is not a priority to me to have a flashlight that I'm carrying around on a clip. I'm just not that much of a flashaholic. And so this version, the aluminum version of the Beta QR, which has two modes, just a 15 lumen mode and a 60 lumen mode, is very practical for me. One of the reasons I think why I end up using this flashlight a lot is also because of the proven emitter. This is a Nichia 219 emitter, which has an excellent color rendering index, which basically means that the kind of light it produces lights up colors in a realistic way. Another reason why I'm using this flashlight a lot over maybe flashlights that are more powerful is just because it's really nice to be able to use a simple AAA battery. Now, this is something that I've come to not take for granted because it seems like the times that your batteries run out are the times that you're, you know, most inconvenienced by the fact that the batteries run out. And this flashlight has been, you know, dropped in lakes, it's been in rainy situations. There's been plenty of times where I've been glad to just throw in a disposable AAA, and it's worked really well. So this flashlight for me is really about just a couple certain features that have, in my everyday carry, made it very difficult to replace. Now, one thing that I would like to see in a future iteration of this flashlight is the improvement of the spring that's in the tail cap. Basically, this split ring in there does sometimes cause a flashlight to fall off. So maybe something even like 10 or 15% thicker or stronger would make it a even more reliable item for me. But in the meantime, I can't recommend it enough. I think it's an amazing flashlight. I think it's a really smart and relatively affordable purchase as well. I'd love to hear from you guys what flashlights have been your long haulers. Let me know in the comments below. Appreciate a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. And as always, make sure to hit that subscribe button if you're new to the channel. Thanks a lot for watching.